And what I am going to talk on this subject is purely on the basis of sadhana only, because this path of different yogas are for the purpose of sadhana. Now sadhana means what? Moving towards from ignorance to the knowledge, from ego, small I, to my real infinite I. To reach that state, there are different sadhanas are there. The first thing, we have to remove our wrong concept about sadhana. We are thinking that there are different paths are there. There is karma yoga, one path. With this karma yoga, you can reach the ultimate reality. For other people, some people, is a bhakti yoga. So from bhakti yoga, you can reach the ultimate. Some people tell that there is a raja yoga. From raja yoga, we can reach the ultimate. And there is also jnana yoga, kundalini yoga, this yoga, that yoga. There are so many yogas are daily in India taking birth. But Lord is telling that there are only two paths. One is karma yoga, another is jnana yoga. Only two paths. Then what about bhakti yoga? What about Raja Yoga? What about Kundalini Yoga? What about that yoga, this yoga? All these yogas are coming under Karma Yoga only. All yogas. Lord Krishna is putting all the yogas in Karma Yoga only. So clearly he has mentioned in 3rd chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Lokesh means Vividhanishta. Pura Prokta Mayana. Jnana Yogena Sankhyanam Karma Yogena Yoginam. So these are the two paths. So Karma Yoga is the means and Jnana Yoga is the end. You understand? So in this Karma Yoga you can add Bhakti Yoga is the means and Jnana Yoga is the end. You can add your Raja Yoga here. Raja Yoga is the means and Jnana Yoga is the end. Okay. And afterwards, Jnana Yoga is the means and liberation is the end. Jnana Yoga is not an end itself. So Jnana Yoga is only a means for what? Ultimate mukti. Okay, so Karma Yoga is helping us for Jnana Prapti. With that Jnana Prapti, I will liberate myself and I will reach the state of that Mukti, liberation or realization, whatever you can talk. So my talk is today talk or tomorrow's talk or next other talk about Jnana Yoga or Bhakti Yoga. Is purely on the basis of sadhana. Now, you may ask why we have to do sadhana. When you put this question, then you have to ask yourself whether you are happy with yourself in present state. Are you completely happy? If you ask yourself, the reply is what? We are not happy. Otherwise, we would have not come here for doing this course. Or we are not running after so many objects of the world. Or we are not morning, evening, we are doing so many things. For what purpose we are doing? For what purpose we are doing? For happiness. Means what? I am not in present state, I am not happy. So I want to be happy. So for that purpose, what you are doing? We are doing so many actions. We are running after so many objects of the world. We are doing so many things. to become happy. Okay. Now for that purpose, we should know that what is this happiness? Why we are running off after this all these things? So we should know that. Means what? We are at present not complete. Liberation means what? The state where you are feeling that what? I am complete. I don't require anything. That completeness will come. The fulfillment is coming. That's called the state of realization. In the state of realization, you don't require anything. You don't run after anything. It's a complete state. It is. Like that, for example, if when you are hungry, what you will do? You want to fill your stomach by eating something. Because you are hungry, you want to satiate that hunger. Now, you have gone to a marriage party, you have eaten up to this, you can, no other thing you can put. Now, when you are completely full, again, if you come here, if Raji did it, tells, I have made a payasam, can you have? Then what you will tell? I just had that also complete this. When you are complete, then there is no desire at all. In completeness, in realization, in liberation, the state of liberation, have completeness in you. Then there is no more desire. When there is no desire, then what happens? You don't run. Wherever you are in the state. So that's the state of the stha pradya. We might have heard the word stha pradya. A state of a jnani. He's completely full. Now we are not feeling that completeness. We are not feeling that what? Fulfillment. So because of we are running. Thinking that this I plus that become complete. This plus that become complete. This plus that become complete. Like that, we are running. Okay. So we are running after that. If I am having this, when I have this, I become complete. It's only what is called mirage. We are telling you mirage. In mirage means what? You know? What is mirage? In the desert. Okay, you are thirsty. Then what you'll do at the time of around 12 o'clock, you are thirsty and you are walking on the desert. If you feel that there is a water, there is, you are seeing that there is a water flowing. So you are going there, but there is no water. So when you go reach there is no water. And again you see something, oh, there is river. Because of what? That's refractory of the sun rays, it creates a type of river, and because of you are moving there, but then there is no river, no water. So like that you are go on moving. So like that in this world we are running for what? To become complete. But we never complete, because why? With finite objects you cannot become infinite. Is it possible? What is the state of that realization? Infinity. Infinity. Okay. The state is realization is infinity. Infinite. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma yo vedanitam guhayam parameyo man. Like that is our Upanishad tells. What? It is a satyam jnanam anantam. Anantam is infinite. Where you don't require anything. Now, what is your desire? To become infinite. And you want to become infinite with what? With objects of the world which are finite. So, in the science, what is that? Any number of finite things cannot make you infinite. The simple principles. Any number of finite cannot make you infinite. Okay. So it is only unnecessary you are putting effort in. We are running. It is called my Guruji's teacher. It is a rat race. Rat race. We are running in the rat race. and rat race, what happens? Ultimately, even if you win that rat race, still you become what? Rat only. In rat race, even though if you win, you become a rat. So, we try to understand what the different sadhanas. Sadhanas, which are different sadhanas, are the Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, or Raj Yoga, and whatever they are. These are the different sadhanas. Okay. With these sadhanas, we go to the what? Jnana Yoga or Jnana Prapti. When we get the Jnana Prapti, okay, then we become complete. Means that is a different subject, we'll talk afterwards then. Now today we'll talk about the Karma Yoga. So as I told you, there are only two paths. One is what? Lifestyles, it's called. Lifestyle. One is Karma Yoga and there is Jnana Yoga. Okay. So Karma Yoga is what? Make fit for Jnana Yoga. As a Karma Yoga is a means and Jnana Yoga is the end. Okay. So it will make us fit for the Jnana Yoga. And from Jnana Yoga, okay, is becoming means for our realization. So when we talk about Jnana Yoga, we talk about Jnana Yoga. Now, before talking about Karma Yoga, we should know why we have to practice Karma Yoga. Before that, we should know what is this Karma Siddhanta. Karma Siddhanta, we should know, everybody. Now, it's a very interesting subject. If everybody has been there, it is nice. Okay, it's the most important. Now, as we are all Hindus, we believe in what? Previous Janmas. And Punar Janma also. Now, this, before this birth, we had some births. Our scriptures are telling you there are millions of births. Okay. Millions of births. Maybe some donkeys, maybe some cows, maybe birds, animals, this one, that one, so many. Or some human beings also. Or this time we may be male or female. In previous germ we may be, if we are female, I may be last germ, it may be male. If I am a male, last birth, I may be female. And this life, I am having my own what? Father, mother, this relation, this. Similarly, every birth I had a what? A father, yes. A mother, this one, that one, children. Yeah. But we don't know that. Really is the blessed we are, because the past memories you have forgotten. If it is again, if you recollect, will become our life become miserable. The last death may be some more donkeys. Then, it's horrible. I was donkey last day. God has given what? It's a blessing to forget all these things. So, in Yoga Shastra, all, if you want to know your previous birth, there is that. In Patanjali Yoga Sutra, there is that. Sadhana is that. Okay. If you, he said that if you practice all this Yama Niyama, so we'll come to now the previous verse, all this. So that's a different state. Then you laugh. Hare, I was what? What are what? Jalmas I have taken. Now, what is Karma Siddhanta? Now, you have taken this birth. Okay. It is not accident. Now she has born in some family, you are born in other family, he has born in somewhere other place, I have born somewhere in some other place. So different people in different places. She is in Calcutta, somebody is in foreign, somebody is in. So for this birth, there is some, what? Some reason is there. Huh? This is the effect. There is a cause is there. Okay, cause and effect is there. Now, to take this birth, when we have taken this birth, for what purpose we have taken this birth? To undergoing the different experiences. This is most important. Different experiences we have to undergo. Can close this. Now, in this life, we are undergoing different experiences, good or bad, both. It is a mixture, it is. It is not that only good, no, or only bad, no. Then life becomes horrible. So, it is a mixture of good and bad. Okay, different experience we are undergoing. Now, when we have taken birth, we are doing a lot of actions. We are doing actions, no? Different actions we are doing. When we are doing different actions, sir, what is the principle of action? Action brings the
reaction
or in the form of result. Okay. It may be in this life or it may be what you call stored in future times. You understand? Yes. Now, this birth is the result of the fruit of past actions of not one life, of millions of lives. You understand? Because every action brings what? The fruit of that action in different times. Time is different. For example, I'll tell you. When you keep some funds in bank, what happens? You are keeping the funds as a deposit at different times. Okay. And when you will get the, what do you call?
Maturity.
The maturity in different time. Some may be 1 year, maybe some are 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years or 30 years. For different time, as per your what you call that deposit. As per the deposit, okay, you may got immediately after 6 months or a year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. Okay, similarly, the actions which are there, okay, we have done millions of billions of actions in previous lives. Now, all the actions they don't yield fruit at a time. Okay. Different time is being. Now, whatever fructified actions are there of past lives, fructified. Okay. So, suppose I tell you, small example I'll give you. Listen it clearly. Instead of writing, understanding is important. Suppose there are three types of actions. It's called Sanchita Karma. Actions are called Karma. Sanchita Karma. And there is called Prarabdha Karma. And third one is called Agami Karma. Sanchita Karma means what? So, total accumulated actions. Total accumulated actions. Is that? Like a bank. Whatever we have done actions, it's depositing that. Whatever actions, good or bad, go on depositing. Till that actions bank exhaust, we have to go on take the
birth.
Punarapi janana, punarapi maranam. So, sanchita karma, whatever is there, it's called sanchita. Sanchita means what? Accumulated. whatever actions are accumulated, we have to exhaust that, because the actions are belongs to whom? So me, not this body. Inside the body is called jiva. For this jiva, there is no death. Body, you know, is going. But jiva is moving from one birth to other birth, other birth to other birth, till it exhausts, taking different type of bodies. Different type of bodies. It go on. In this life, we have taken this birth. Okay. Next life, some other birth. It depends upon the fruit of the action. Now, for this birth, the fructified actions of whatever the sanchita karma is there, accumulated, in that some actions are fructified. So, we example we'll take an example. There are some 10,000 actions are there. Out of, there are billions are there. We take for example, 10,000 actions are there in sanchita karma. Now, out of that, 1,000 actions are fructified. Suppose, for example, I tell you, there are 10,000 mangoes are there. At a time, 10,000 mangoes which are raw. At a time, it's not got become, what do you call, ripen. Different time it ripens, no? In a tree also, if everything it ripens, means you have to throw, because you cannot eat everything. So, God has given in a tree the mangoes, okay? Then what happens? It ripens different time. No? Then what happens? You can enjoy all the fruits. Other, if it's one day fine morning, all the 10,000 mangoes of the tree, if it's ripened and fell down, then what happens? Guess what? You cannot enjoy. So, the 10,000 actions which are there, for example, I'm only, huh? There are billions. So, 10,000 actions, only 1,000 actions are fructified. Now, this fructified means what? These are giving result. It's a result. Huh? Now, it has to, I have to enjoy that fruit I have to enjoy, because I have done the actions. I am without the jiva. And I have to enjoy that actions. That fruit. Now, it is karma siddha in this like that. To enjoy that fruit of that my actions, what type of body is required? So I am going to decide. You understand? In Patanjali Yoga Sutra is there. The three things are fixed: ayu, bhoga, and jati. That sutra is there. In Patanjali Yoga Sutra, jati means what? Which jati? Human being, as a human being, or a bird, as an animal, or whatever may be. I am going to decide. Why? In which body that fruit can be, fruit of that action can be enjoyed or experienced. Enjoyed means what?
Experience.
Okay. For that, so jati, I decide.
A human being.
I tell you. Listen. After saying questions, sir, you can tell me. Listen, it is very interesting. It's my, this one story only it is. Karma Yoga, if you are, then better you understand. Now, out of 1,000, so I'll see which body is required. So, I choose body. When I choose body to undergo that experience, sir, I choose the parents. Because, and where the parents have to experience that this one. Suppose I am having a I enjoy and undergo experience of music. If I take a birth in a place where there is no iota of music at all, then I cannot undergo the experience of music. So I take such a parent I choose where I can experience my music habit. You understand? Like that. In 6th chapter it is coming beautifully. Arjuna is asking. Ayati Shraddha Yoga Peto Yoga Chanta Manasa. Means what? As person is I am, or you are all doing sadhana, and before reaching the your goal, you die. Then sadhana gone, sadhana is gone. Then no. Partha neveha namutra vinashastasya vidyate nahi kalyana kutkashit durgati tata gachit. No, there is no durgati. What happens? Whatever punya papa is there, he will enjoy in different lokas. Again he will come back. Where he will come back? Where the sadhana is halfway and stop, no? To continue that, he choose the parents. Which home, if I take my birth, I can continue that sadhana. If your music is there, if you have learned half music, to continue that, so which parents I have to take birth? Which your family, your children, if you are taking birth, they have taken also what they have chosen you as a parent, and you are also chosen it is there. Okay, it's not only one side, it's both the side. You have, can you may ask, I don't know what type of child I have had. Are you only chosen that? And you have to also undergo that experience. That child also has to undergo experience under this atmosphere, and you also go under experience. You have to fulfill your that fruit. You understand? You have to undergo that experience. So like that, if it's good, good experience. If it's bad, bad experience, you have to undergo that. That name is called Prarabdham. Arey, there are Prarabdham. Prarabdham is what we are telling you, thinking bad. No, good also Prarabdham only. Good also Prarabdham only. Okay, it's a good Prarabdham or bad Prarabdham. So, one is Sanchita Karma. Second, so as per the fruit of the actions, okay, fruit of the actions, what will happen? I will take a body. With that 1000 what? Fructified actions, I take a body. Now you have taken body. So you are a human being. Okay. Now you have taken. Out of the 10,000, what happened? How much reduced? Out of 10,000 accumulated, 1000 reduced, no? You have taken a body. Yes. Then how many balance that?
9,000.
9,000 is there. Okay. No, till those 9,000 get exhausted, I have to take what?
Birth.
Birth.
Next.
Birth
will be taken only for 1,000.
This birth only 1,000 only. If only 1,000 birth are 1,000 actions are fructified. All are not, 9,000 are not fructified. Only 1,000 only fructified. I give example of mango, no? All 10,000 mangoes suddenly not get them. So some are getting. Or 10,000 out of 1,000 is all fructified. And now you are enjoying 1,000 mangoes. Enjoying means what? You have to undergo that.
Experience.
Now, I told you, Patanjali is saying that jati, bhoga, bhoga means experience. Ayu, to that exhausted 1000 fruit of that actions, how much time is required in this body? How many days you have to live in this body? That also only you only decide. Whether it is 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 50 years, 100 years, you only decide, because till that it has to exhaust 1,000 that fructified actions, it has to exhaust. So in different time, as per as you grow, different time it comes and what, you have to undergo the experience. Understand? As a child, all the 1,000 you cannot have that. So as you grow, so one by one experiences you are growing. You understand? Now, after that exhaustion of 1,000, now again, we'll die. And after death, what happens? Out of 9,000, some of them again, 55. Now again, we have to take one more body. What body? Maybe bird body. So, that experience, suppose only 50 actions are 55. To that 55, 50 actions, only there are only What? You required a bird body. Bird body. Only those. Because human body is not possible that.
It's little.
Yeah. It's only 50. No, not because it's that experience are different. That experiences are maybe different. Okay. That experience, to undergo that experience, you require a different body. You understand? Different body. You understand this important. You understand? No, as per the fructified actions, what type of experiences? Experience, which body you can have that. Suppose, what I tell you.
If I want to go into bird body, so like what type of experiences will be there?
Birds are whatever the experience they are doing, undergoing. Okay, they are flying. Suppose flying experience should be required. Now, human body you can fly? No, you cannot fly. Because you may be had an intense desire to fly. Now, intense desire, when they're flying, intense desire there, the human body cannot fly. What type of body is required?
Bird
body. Suppose you are having intense desire to swim. Okay, wearing sari you can swim. So what required? A dress is required which is suited for swimming. Okay. Suppose if you want to go to Chandraloka, like this dress can go to there. No? You might have seen that astronauts, how they are wearing. Because a different dress is required. Okay. So, to undergo that 50 experiences, so you require to get, suppose, I give an example. So, you require a body of flying body. Which, where we can fly? As a bird. Suppose you want to be in the water only, that intense desire, at water only. What body is required?
Fish
body. Then what will you do? You take fish body. We go there. No, that is important, not important. The important thing is, you understand, that is important. Now, suppose you have taken this birth of what? As a human body. To exhaust that 1000 fruit of that action. Okay. After that,